just a man of sorrows. He is acquainted with grief, wounded for our transgressions. By his stripes we are healed. No beauty that we should desire him. Despised and rejected by men. He came to his own, they forsook him. Led to the cross as a lamb. Now there's no other name by which men can be saved. So Lord, I come.
He must deny himself, take up his cross and follow me. I have been crucified with Christ. I have been put to death with Christ. It's not Peter Scott who's living anymore, but Christ lives within me. He lives through me. As if God is speaking to you right now to turn. Turn from your ways and turn to God. Find forgiveness, find hope. Find eternal salvation. Find Christ. He's there. Offering up those nail-pierced hands in which he died for you. Did you know that? Pray to God that you come to the realization of that, because I got the realization that Christ died for me. That Christ will give me the power over sin. And that's why I preach this, because I know he can give you power over whatever you're going through. He can give you power over the grave, because he has that power. Power over the death that's coming if you do not have Christ. Right? The wages of sin is death. The paycheck for sin is death. But the gift of God, my friend, is eternal life. I have gotten that gift, and it's free. You can't work your way for it. You can't do anything for it. But Christ will give. Christ will redeem. Christ will restore you. Christ will forgive you. He's a refuge in time of trouble. He loves those who fear him. He died for you, man. That the question is, do you know God? Are you born again? Do you have newness of life? If anyone isn't in Christ, if anyone is in Christ, he's a new creation. Old things have passed away. My old life has passed away. It's been crucified. And new things have come. And new things will come. Christ is there. Opening his hand for you. Do you know him? Is he going to say come in, or is he going to say depart from me? That's the question you got to ask yourself. Not if you finish the race, but the question is, did you come into Christ? Do you know Christ? Do you? And he came to seek and to save. That's what is lost. I was lost. And he came to seek and to save me. He left the 99 sheep to come for me, that one sheep. That rebellious one. But he ran to me and he forgave me. And he died for me. And he took my dishonor and gave me his honor. That I am not a vessel for dishonor any longer. But I am a vessel for honor. Not of wrath, but of honor. And he is my refuge. He is my strength. He is my tower. I don't run to the things I once used to run to. I run to Christ. And I find forgiveness. I find love. And I find freedom. Are the chains broken? Are you still striving? Are you still trapped? Are you still locked up? The key has been made. The price has been paid. Come. Come. There's a dinner being prepared. There is a place being prepared. There's one being prepared for you. If not, you will be rejected. Don't be rejected. Don't neglect such great a salvation. It's here. I found it. It's been given to me. Freely. Is your debt paid? Amen. Right on, man. He says, come. Come, let us reason, says the Lord. You ever reason with somebody before? He says, let us reason. Though your sins are as scarlet, that scarlet, deep red. Though they're as crimson, he's going to make them white as wool. He'll make them white as snow. He'll forgive you. That black stain of that sin can be washed away. You can find peace. That peace that transcends all understanding. It'll guard your heart and your mind. But do you know God? That's the question. That's the question. Do you know God? Have you found forgiveness? Have you been forgiven? Washed by the blood. Hallelujah. There's power in the blood. I found that power and it gave me strength. Gave me strength to beat my addictions. Gave me strength to beat all my fears. And he gave me love, power, and a sound mind. He gave me that spirit that raised Christ from the dead.